And I want to just bring in Ritesh here because I know Ritesh is also running a hospital that has been begging for oxygen. Ritesh, do you want to tell us what's happening at your hospital? Who you have to beg? I don't even understand the process. What actually happens when the oxygen starts running out? Who do you call? Who calls you back? Does anyone call you back? Ritesh?
So Barkha, I would first like to applaud my previous panelist. I think lovely points for what she has said. When a hospital like ours, which is a 100-bedded hospital, which has close to 60 COVID patients right now, goes out of oxygen, you'll be amazed what happens. This is the most fearful situation for a doctor, and especially when the doctor is the promoter of a small hospital. We are completely clueless. We have no idea from where do we go and ask for oxygen, because usually the oxygen used to come from a vendor of ours. And after calling him 50 times, he picked up our phone and said that there will be no oxygen for you for the next 2 days. And we have 60 patients on dire need of oxygen. On the facility side, we have just 46. On the facility side, we have just 46 beds of COVID, but we are actually accommodating almost 60 patients right now, seeing the load of patients. And it's an appalling situation right now. Now, oxygen is of two types. One is the cylindrical oxygen, which gives roughly 7 cubic millimeter of oxygenation. And one is the liquid oxygen. Now, liquid oxygen gives 167 cubic millimeters of oxygen. And this is something which is missing in Delhi. Usually, and this is very interesting, we do not have even a single liquid oxygen manufacturing plant within the borders of Delhi. We depend on Panipat, we depend on Noida, we depend on Faridabad. Now, the moment our health minister said that health is a state subject, respective CMs started conserving their oxygen capabilities and stopped the large tankers of IOCL at the Panipat border. Now, my question here is, in the national capital of one of the fastest growing and the largest democracies of the world, if we are falling short of oxygen, and only when the load of patients is only twice of that of what happened in the first wave,